International stage. Let's just run through the runners and riders for this competition. So just in case you needed clarification, Kohei Uchimura of Japan to get things underway. He represents Team Solidarity and will be competing on the vault. So the reigning Olympic champion, the two-time all-around champion, he's had a very tough time of things lately, a well-documented tough time of things, but it is now chance to see Kohei Uchimura to get things underway. And it's like he's never been away. There we go. That will do very nicely indeed, that reaction into the big beam. Tells us that Kohei Uchimura is a man delighted to be back. With his characteristic precision, his delightful execution. Very clean, lovely toe points, heels nicely together. Everything about this well established in terms of the central line of attack. Yeah, that is very, very nice. So the gymnasts can do two vaults should they choose, but only the first vault will count towards the team score. And there is a brand new system in play as the score comes in of 14.5. So Uchimura, 14.5 his score. Now we have a look at Arthur Dellaloyan. Taking to the still ring. So as I was saying earlier, a new system is being used for the calculation of the vault. It's a brand new judging support system. We'll come back to that later. And apologies if any of you have had difficulty with the audio at the start of the broadcast. We're doing our utmost to rectify that. No problems here, though, for Dellaloyan. This is a delightfully clean work on the gymnast representing Team Friendship. What a lovely start. This has been the first couple of routines that we've had a chance to look at have been examples of stellar execution as we now go to Wataru Tanikawa, the 24-year-old World Championship team bronze medalist for the last two competitions. Oh, he did get enormous amplitude, a little too much amplitude, unfortunately. Ginastica had some difficulties at the World Championship last year. He was injured. As Dalaloyan's score is 14.5 on the still rings. Now to the uneven bars, Angelina Melnikova. Gymnast representing Team Friendship alongside Dalaloyan. Very nice, clean, clear transition into the pack salto, and then adds in a half turn. Jaeger somersault was fluid. Just came up a little bit short perhaps on that handstand, but nothing too problematic. It's a lovely start to the competition we're seeing here. Some very fine gymnastics from all of these athletes who obviously have been so desperate to get back out into competition. Tanigawa with a score of 14 for his vault. Tanigawa representing Team Solidarity. And we'll try to give you a clear picture of how things are looking at the end of this first rotation. We have the still rings and the uneven bars in play for Team Friendship, and the vault and the balance beam in play for Team Solidarity. Melnikova with a score of 14.5 for her work on the uneven bars. Did compete in the Toyota International at the end of last year in this country, winning the uneven bars there. To a very well-known figure in the Japanese team, Kazuma Kaya, 23-year-old reigning Japanese all-around champion from just a couple of months ago. So to the still rings for Kaya. Just a little adjustment as he goes into that first sprint hold. Jonasson and just opens up the palms to demonstrate his strength. Very emphatic going into that straddle planche. Strong gymnastics we are seeing here. It's a lovely start to this competition. Kazuma Kaya becoming a really ubiquitous figure in Japanese teams and indeed in all around gymnastics. He was the silver medalist in the all around at the national championships last year. Lovely moment for him to take the title earlier this year. So just a reminder that only the top three scores on each apparatus are counted. It's 14.1 for Kazuma Kaya. So that is a lower score than we've just seen from Arta Dalaloyan. Also representing Team Friendship is Yuya Kamoto, the 26-year-old from Tokyo. Home city moment here for the Youth Olympic Games all-around champion from 2010. How lovely it was to see Kamoto making his World Championship debut last year, taking a team bronze. It looked as though it might not happen earlier in the year when he fractured his jaw at the National Championships. Skill there, the change of the arm position in the handstand from what we've seen so far. Nothing to a straight branch. Oh, he's done well to put perhaps a touch of improvisation into that. Well, that's great strength to rescue a little loss in the arms. Yamamoto swings round for a well-controlled dismount, actually. Had a few exciting moments in it for all the right reasons and all the wrong reasons, but he did very well indeed. Graduate of the physical education course at Nippon Sports Science University here in Tokyo, same place as his teammate Uchimura, and indeed Kenzo Shirai, and about 10 million other fantastic Japanese gymnasts. That's a really interesting combination. Some of the gymnasts will be trying out some new things at this competition. As we look at Asuka Teramoto on the uneven bars, gymnast from Komaki in the centre of Japan. And she's had dreadful injury troubles of late. Great that she's back in competition. Stole her into the Kachev. Was nice and secure. A lot going on in this routine from Asuka Teramoto into the overshoot, and that was controlled with precision. We are seeing some superb gymnastics. It's been very much worth the wait. There's been a hubbub of excitement about this competition. The gymnasts themselves have just said they are so thrilled to be having this opportunity to take to the competition floor. Which I said right as there was a yawning gymnast in the background, bang on cue. But no, they really have all spoken with such excitement about this, as indeed have the gymnastics fan base as well, of which you are evidently a part if you're watching this, especially some of the unsociable hours you might well be watching it. Yuya Komoto's score is a 14.2 on the still rings for Team Friendship. But it's going to take us a little while to get a handle on which scores are going to be kept and which are going to be discarded. Asuka Teramoto picks up a 13.5 for her work on the uneven bars. So we have six rotations. Last two rotations, as you might expect, will solely feature the male competitors, some of whom we haven't had the chance to have a look at yet. And there is action going on the vault for men and on the balance beam for the women in Team Solidarity. going to have a look now at some of the best of that action with Zhang Jin of the People's Republic of China, the 19-year-old balance beam medalist at the Asian Games. And she competed in Milwaukee back in March, one of the few competitions that did take place this year. She was the top performer on the beam there. Well, she is highly accomplished on this apparatus, Zhang Jin. And the score of 14.4 could be a very tidy one, a very useful one for Team Solidarity. So we have concluded the first rotation of the competition. And so that brings us to Nikita Nagorny on the vault. In fact, that's the first half of the first rotation, excuse me, because we are operating a split warm-up system. So Nikita Nagorny, oh, that's big stuff. Just a little look of slight confusion on his face at the conclusion of that vault. The reigning world and European all-around champion got big, big amplitude. Just a little hop back or two. Hitomi Hatakeda, representing Team Friendship on the uneven bars. Reigning Japanese champion on this apparatus. Haxalto, such a popular transition point from high to low. No issues whatsoever for Hitomi Hatakeda. It's been the story of the day so far for just about every gymnast that we've had the chance to see. Most has gone extremely well, and we expect that with the uneven bars and Hatakeda. Nagorny scores a 14.6 for his vault. Zhang Boheng on the still rings for Team Friendship. Chinese athlete from Hunan province. Made the still rings final at the last year's Chinese national championships, where he was fifth. Good level shoulder line in his iron cross. Oh. really did get the knees tucked in nicely and tightly for that Yamawaki skill. Stable in his dismount, happy with that performance by the sound of things is Zhang Bohe. The number in for Hitomi Hadakeda, it's 13.9. Zhang Boheng, 14.7 for him on the steel rings. That is going to be a score that will be very important for Team Friendship. Higher by a couple of tenths from the score posted by Arta Dallaloya, and that'll do very nicely. He's not going to be performing on all of the pieces, Zhang. Now a chance to look at MJ Frazier from the United States of America. International debut for this first year senior from New Jersey. First time that she has ever travelled outside of the United States of America. She's been highly complimentary of the safety measures at the competition and how well everyone is being looked after by the organisers. You enjoyed that look at MJ Frazier. We'll probably come back to her later on in the competition as we now turn our attention to Dimitri Lankin of Team Solidarity. Same team competing on vault. And he certainly got a bit of distance away from the vaulting table. Now to MJ Frazier. First real moment where she's had a little instability in what's been a really secure performance. And sometimes that happens, doesn't it? At one moment follows another. Very promising, though, towards the first part of the routine from MJ Frazier. Good recovery, too. What a nice dismount that was. Plenty of good signs for the 16-year-old. As I mentioned, international debut for her. And it's a big competition to drop yourself into and to be a part of with the competitors that are out there. She wasn't too far away from managing to stay on the apparatus. Got back on and put it behind her very rapidly. Gymnast who was sixth on the balance beam at last year's Junior National Championships as Lankin scores 14.6. He was the European Games silver medalist on the vault last year. So has established a bit of a pedigree for that of late. So we are to keep our attentions on Team Solidarity by the looks of things, as MJ Frazier's score is 11.6. Well, MJ Frazier's done my job for me in introducing our next competitor, Shailese Jones, known as Shai, the 18-year-old from the Pacific Northwestern city of Seattle. Almost, big skill. Great to see her at a competition like this. She's been so often very close to making big teams. She's the alternate gymnast for the Pan American Games in Lima last year. Was injured ahead of the World Championship selection camp. And goes down, so that will add to the execution deductions. I think it's worth bearing in mind that, like all of these gymnasts, she lost enormous amounts of training time. Did a lot of conditioning work without much in the way of actual gymnastics. When she went back into the gym, she had to use a temporary tumbling track outside her house. So it's not a surprise to see any of these athletes take a moment just to reacclimatize themselves to competition gymnastics as opposed to at-home training gym gymnastics. So Shailese Jones, who is expected to be attending Florida in collegiate gymnastics. One of the gymnasts who will be focusing her attention on the delayed Summer Olympiad.
Gymnast, please move to the next apparatus. Thank you.
Hitomi Hadakeda and Asuka Teramoto having a quick chat as they move around to the next rotation. Hitomi's younger sister Chiaki is in Team Solidarity. Not very used to competing against each other in a team context, the Hatakeda sisters. They're very used to it in an individual sense at national championship level. We shall be moving on to the next rotation in a short while, the second of the six rotations. So don't worry if you're just joining the competition now, if you've overslept or are staying up late, or I don't know what time of day or night it is where you are, but wherever it is and whatever time it is, don't worry, you've still got plenty of gymnastics to come. As indeed has this young competitor, starts with a 12.4. Good difficulty going on in that routine. Real potential for some very strong scoring. Be interesting to watch her on vault a little bit later as well. So we have concluded rotation number one here at the FIG Friendship and Solidarity Competition. The gymnasts go through their warm-ups for rotation number two. And we have now the parallel bars in play for Team Friendship. We just have a clarification of the top three scores on the uneven bars for Team Friendship. So it's Melnikova, Zhou and Hatakeda whose scores are counting. Now for Team Solidarity, at the vaulting table. Good scores from Nagorny Lankin and a gentleman you might have heard of called Kohei Uchimura. So all looking good there on the balance beam. Zhang Chiaki Hatakeda and Liu Yufei. We did see the performance of Zhang Jin, overwhelmingly the strongest. So those the counting scores. And what that tells us, as things stand, is it is Team Friendship who has a narrow advantage. But there's a long way still to go in this process. And I think this is one of those occasions when probably we're focusing a little bit less on the numbers than we normally do in the sport of gymnastics because, well, it's just good fun to be watching gymnastics again, isn't it? So this is the start list for Team Friendship on the balance beam. Parallel bars, Yin De Hang will get things underway for Team Solidarity. Arta Dalaloyan, having started with a 14.5 on the steel rings, is now going to vault, something that he does extremely well. Normally, but not on that occasion. Not on that occasion from Arta Dalaloyan, but if you've been watching him for a number of years, you'll know that he's got some high octane and high amplitude work on vault, and that not his finest ever. Part of the same team, Team Friendship. Sophia Butler to the balance beam. Another first year senior, part of this exciting American contingent. Won the all around at a competition in Texas back in February. Well, to hold on to that. Didn't perhaps get the sort of height that she was probably aiming for, but good composure. Just a little bit tentative in getting the legs up towards horizontal. Did just about manage to stay on her feet there. Just escaped away from the camera at the conclusion of that routine, but Sophia Butler acquitting herself very nicely. Dalaloyan with a score of 14.1. Just evidence there of the high degree of difficulty that he's still able to produce that score after that landing. A chance to see Akari Matsumura taking to the floor, the 20-year-old from Nagano. She made her world championship debut in Stuttgart and performed well on the floor. Thank you. What a lovely combination of musical styles in that routine, blended together well by Akari Matsumura. As I mentioned, her best work at the World Championships in Stuttgart came on the floor exercise. For Sophia Butler, it is a score of 12.5. And for Matsumura, 12.6 for her work on the floor exercise. Kazumakaya, with an emphatic cry, gets ready to take to the vault. Scored 14.1 on the still rings. It's just become such a reliable and dependable member of the Japanese team. All-around champion from the World University Games last year. Big side step off the mat, but I think he's pretty happy nonetheless. Plenty to be happy with as well. It was really only a handful of degrees away from having that absolutely bang on. Known for his big emotional reactions after performing is Kazumakaya, and his score 14.2. So a controlled and composed looking start on the still rings, followed by some high amplitude work at the vault. We head to the floor exercise and a first chance to look at Chiaki Hatakeda, the younger sister of Hitomi, on the other team. This is now Team Solidarity and a senior international debut for Hatakeda. She's a gymnast who people have been talking about for some time. Fair to say, a gymnast of quite considerable promise is Chiaki Hatakeda. And she had a difficult time of things at the national championships. Nikita Nagorny to the parallel bars. Reigning world champion, reigning European champion in all-around gymnastics. Using the single rail for that handstand just adds a little bit of difficulty. Does lots on just one rail and that shows real control. For the most part, it's got very good toe point in this routine. dismounts well, just stabilizes it with a little movement at the end, but technically what he did with his legs in that routine was very sound. Adakeda's score for the floor exercise is 13 dead on. We'll wait to see if that's a counting score. Nikita Nagorny scores 14.7 on the parallel bars. Our focus now to team friendship on the balance beam. Asuka Teramoto, the Japanese all-around champion last year, and she won the balance beam competition at the All Japan Event Championships shortly after it. Graduate of physical education at Chukyo University in the city of Nagoya. Actually very well known for its production of elite skaters. Interestingly, Teramoto was a gymnast who actually looked as though in her very early days she was going to start in the world of rhythmic gymnastics, but after a matter of days moved across to artistic gymnastics because she wanted to get at the bar. Well known, I'm sure, to many of you for her performances at the Olympic Games. Finished as high as eighth in the all-around competition at the Olympiad. So you're looking here at Team Friendship, who are also competing on the vault. Just put up the three men on the vault, Dalaloyan, Rostov and Kaya. But a full quota of competitors on the balance beam. Just a reminder that it is the top three scores on each apparatus that count, leading to a running total that at the moment has Team Friendship ahead by just over half a mark of Team Solidarity. It's a fascinating space, isn't it? The Yoyogi First Gymnasium, the architecture of which I'm sure I will bore you with a little bit later, but let us now look at the work of Asuka Teramoto on the balance beam. Had a few almost moments on the beam so far today, that another of them, but as I mentioned a moment ago, with so many performers, all seven of them competing on the balance beam, there is the opportunity for some discarded scores. Something that probably takes many of you back to some of the older days of team competitions. Asuka Teramoto concluding her routine with obviously that moment earlier on that will provide for clear execution deduction. But otherwise, plenty that went well. Started with a confident mount of the apparatus. Tomi Hatakeda watching on. Showed a lot of leg strength there in that landing. She was a touch compressed. Dealt with it well. So a look back at Zhou Ruyu from the People's Republic of China. 17-year-old on the balance beam. Reigning Asian all-around champion. And that was her senior international debut when she won that in Ulaanbaatar last year. Very crisp so far. Well, that is tidy indeed and interesting from Zhou Ruyu. Her score 12.5. Not the most enormous difficulty score, but a very thorough routine from the 17-year-old. Still waiting for Asuka Teramoto's score on balance beam. And there it is, 12.2. Higher difficulty than the gymnast we've just seen, but the execution obviously a little different. Hitomi Hatakeda from one of the great gymnastics families of the world now, it has to be said. Father Yoshiaki, team bronze medalist at the Olympic Games in Barcelona. Accomplished coach as well, Mother Yukiko Universiad medalist, where Hitomi then went last year to win four gold medals, including on the balance beam. And now Chiaki is in the picture as well. Fascinating family. Yes, that is likely to be a score of significance for Team Friendship. Hitomi Hatakeda knows it as well. Impressive. Jana Vorona is the next to go, followed by her teammate at national level, Angelina Melnikova. A good horizontal position in the leap, and then just making sure that some of the finer details, such as the toe point, are not neglected in this routine. And she was secure moving around into that dismount. Gymnast who really has grown in confidence and stature over the last little while. Dimitri Lankin to compete on the parallel bars. Haven't seen him a huge amount at international level compared to some of his teammates. It's very difficult to just get your way into the Russian team. Oh, didn't he arrest that well? It looked like he was going a little bit off axis. Yes, that was always going to be difficult to hold on to, and it's one of the cruel things about gymnastics is just a little loss of form can lead to a very high deduction. And the gymnast dismounts unintentionally from the apparatus, as I'm sure many of you know, they hemorrhage a full mark. Nice stole the work on the single rail. Just a little momentary adjustment as he tried to link those two elements. Good travel there though, plenty of distance. Couple of stumbles back from Dmitry Lankinser. Some clear execution deductions throughout that routine, but again, we put it into the wider context of it taking time for these gymnasts to recover their form. 13.7 is the score for Hitomi Hatakeda on the balance beam. That one might well be used. Yana Vorona of the Russian Federation, 15-year-old. She has competed at a couple of World Cup events. She was due to be in the balance beam final in Baku before that competition was cancelled after qualifications due to the current pandemic. One has to feel for gymnasts like Vorona, who's transition through to the senior ranks has been a most interrupted one. Well, there are some exciting signs there, aren't there, in Yana Vorona. Dmitry Lankin's score is 11.4. The execution down at 5.6. Wataru Tanigawa, representing Team Solidarity, takes to the parallel bars. Gentleman who is a graduate of sports science at Juntendo University, or Jundai, another esteemed sporting institution in Japan. And he's been very successful for the national team in World University events. Just got a few little adjustments here and there, just completing some of his skills in slight installments. Just knocks the odd tenth or two off. Nice and clean arching the back. Really goes into that V position with clarity. And again, oh, isn't that a lovely dismount? Oh, crisp and clean. There's a lovely little snap to his manner position and then a flourish as he goes round into a well-stuck landing. That's fine gymnastics from Wataru Tanigawa. For Yana Vorona, 12.8 on the balance beam. Angelina Melnikova, representing Team Friendship. An Olympic medalist, a medalist in just about everything. She's been very emphatic about the fact that she believes that she's come back after this break, older, healthier, more mature. She says she treats the sport differently now and thinks that's really been helping her. She's been using the time to read a great deal, to study the English language. She's not the only gymnast during this absence of sport, indeed not the only elite athlete across all sports who have commented on how a little bit of time for perspective has been helpful. Very stable Wolf turn. Very stable everything. Well, I think it's safe to say that Team Friendship will be using that one. That's a strong performance from Angelina Melnikova. First competition of 2020 for her. What a nice line established there. Very level. Well executed in the pike position too. .14.8 for Wataru Tanegawa on the parallel bars. Potentially a useful score that for Team Solidarity. So it brings to a close the rotation. Angelina Melnikova scores 14.1 on the balance beam. And that is a really good and big score for Team Friendship. We'll give you an update in a moment on which scores are being carried through and what that means for the totals. So for Team Friendship, Kazumakaya, Arta Dalaloyan, Alexei Rostov, the vaulting scores that are being used. They did only put three competitors up on vault, so no surprise those are the three. No surprise either that Angelina Melnikova and Hitomi Hatakeda's performances on the balance beam are scores that counted. And Wataru Tanegawa producing the top performance on the parallel bars for Team Solidarity. Yin Dehang in there with a 14.1 display. On the floor exercise, Chiaki Hatakeda, 13, the strongest score posted. Alexandra Shkoldina, also part of the three scores that are counting. And it tells us then that Team Friendship remain in the lead, 169 to 167.4. But still a little way to go. Well, more than a little way to go. We are at the 1/3 mark of the competition. Yuya Komoto and Kazumakaya will be competing in this rotation. Horizontal bar coming into play. And there's the start list for Team Solidarity on the horizontal bar. And we will see Kohei Uchimura, who's making himself a horizontal bar specialist. So I think it's safe to say everybody will be watching with enormous excitement to see what he delivers on this apparatus. The gap, just for those of you who are counting, has grown by a full mark. So Team Friendship, they were 0.6 ahead at the conclusion of the first rotation. They are now 1.6 up. But instead of listening to that, I know what you're doing. You're just thinking about whether Kohei Uchimura is going to deliver what we hope he'll deliver on the horizontal bar and complete what would be one of the most romantic stories in gymnastics as he gets to the Olympic Games. That means more to him, in his own words, than any other thing in his career. And that is up against some pretty stiff competition, because Kohei Uchimura turns up to stuff and wins it. That's kind of all he does. We begin then the third rotation of this Friendship and Solidarity competition. It is Team Friendship on the floor. Liu Jieyu from the People's Republic of China, bronze medalist on the floor exercise at the Asian Championships in Mongolia last year. And she was eighth in the all-around at the recent Chinese National Championships in Jiaoqing in September. Liu Jieyu is one of those gymnasts that we haven't seen an enormous amount of at international level. And it does just remind one, when you look at a performance like that, of the strength in depth that exists in the Chinese women's team. Yuya Kamoto takes to the parallel bars for Team Friendship. Didn't compete on vault, so this following his 14.2 on the steel rings. A wonderfully stable handstand. Good height, really got a bit of take off. Oh yes, lovely travel again. That was a slightly nervy moment as he dismounted, a bit of a clunk. But he's just such an interesting athlete, is Yuya Kamoto. Just things about him that really make him stand out as a competitor. Stylistically, he's very memorable. Some of his composition is very interesting. We've got some fun stuff coming up now for you on the horizontal bar. Nikita Nagorny. Just a little bit short, getting into position there. He's fine with his straight Kachev. Straight Kachev using the mixed grip for variety. The more familiar straddle Kachev, and again into the mixed grip. Quite a common arrangement of Kachev's that, in terms of the way horizontal bar routines are constructed. Oh, and he just lands that like a man who's walked into the room. That was very, very light and gentle in terms of his finishing position. Said he felt so emotional coming back to Round Lake for national team training in July. Fascinatingly, his guitar string broke in lockdown. Couldn't get a new one. So he started playing the keyboard instead. Yu Jiayu with a score of 12.9 for her work on the floor exercise. This is the penultimate rotation for the women. Okay then, here we go. Kohei Uchimura has accepted that a defense of his all-around world, or rather Olympic title, will not be happening. He has chosen to focus his attention on one piece of apparatus, on this one. He has chosen to become a horizontal bar specialist. Let us see just what it is that Kohei Uchimura produces for team solidarity and indeed for himself here on the horizontal bar. A lot of people just like him around the world take a breath. First big release and catch coming up. It is huge. And again, oh yes. Oh, yes. Wild, but okay. Yamawaki, he hops over the bar. And the gymnastics world dares to dream. King Kohei, now a horizontal bar specialist, and look at what it means to him. Massive work from one of the finest of all time. Oh, we've waited for that one. Waited with barely a twitch, so frozen in fear have people been. Did well to catch that. Wasn't the perfect line, certainly. But goodness me, is this a big and busy routine. Now, the more that we see that, the more extraordinary it is that he managed to make that work. Welcome back. Few things in life are as fun as seeing gymnasts enjoy gymnastics. 15.2 for Kohei Uchimura. 6.6 difficulty score. That's something to have a bit of fun with, isn't it? Yuya Komoto also a 6.6 difficulty score and a 14.6 on the parallel bars. To Wataru Tanegawa. Nice elevation on his Yamawaki skill. Pacey work this, certainly not wasting any time. Tidy as he dismounts, and a look of great intensity from Wataru Tanegawa. Zhang Jin of the People's Republic of China now to vault, representing Team Solidarity. Gymnast who attends training in Shanghai. So Tanegawa with a score of 14.4 on the horizontal bar. Good numbers being delivered here. And a gentleman who certainly can contribute to that. Shane Whiskers for Team Friendship. Well, to the parallel bars we go, and a look at a gymnast from Minnesota. He's not had an easy time of things of late, has Shane Whiskers. Had to make significant adjustments to his training plans due to the loss of his collegiate gymnastics program, having to finish his undergraduate degree online. But he's just been so philosophical about the whole thing. Hasn't had to make many adjustments here. Well, after the turmoil and turbulence of his gymnastics career of late, it must be a delight just to be out here competing and performing. A lot of tidy gymnastics there from Shane Whiskers. And we shall see him on the horizontal bar in a short while as well. Piece that he is very known for. .14.7 for Zhang Jin on the vault. And for Nikita Nagorny, .14.2 on the horizontal bar. Team Solidarity trailing by 1.6 after the second rotation. Shane Whiskers, 14 for him on the parallel bars. So the split warm-up now continues, and we wait for the next set of gymnasts to take to the apparatus. Just the one on the parallel bars. It is Arthur Dalaloyan. A couple of couple of Japanese gymnasts will be vaulting for Team Solidarity. The floor exercise will be busy. There's nobody on the horizontal bar in this second half of rotation number three, but there will be three gymnasts competing on the floor exercise. So this could be interesting. Shai Jones has a rather impressive double twisting Yurchenko vault, and there is the evidence of it. A 9.4 execution, a score of 14.8. Going to be difficult for people to keep up with the Joneses there. But that was the story, wasn't it, of the last half rotation, was Kohei Uchimura. Just terrific performance on the horizontal bar, 15.2. What on earth has gone through this gentleman's mind over the last year and a half? Dreadful shoulder injuries, had to miss a World Championships. But he's a grounded gentleman who says he doesn't believe in lucky charms, all he believes in is practice. Not a superstitious man, he's just somebody who gets on with the job. There was a little bit of drama before the competition when he had a false positive test for the coronavirus. But no drama in his performance. Should point out though, he has been totally upstaged this year by his mother Shuko, who competed in a gold leopard print leotard at Masters level at the Japanese National Championships at the age of 58. Dalaloyan competing on the parallel bars for Team Friendship. Just has to reset himself a touch. You know what, it is worth just taking a moment to remember how long it's been since these gymnasts competed, because what we are seeing is of a thoroughly high standard. These athletes have missed so much of their careers. Akari Matsumura will vault for Team Solidarity. She scored a 12.6 on floor, which is a counting score. And that was very stable work. .12.9 for Arta Dalaloyan on the parallel bars. Not having the smoothest day by his extremely exacting standards. Akari Matsumura scores 13.4 on vault. Now we still have a couple of gymnasts to compete on the floor exercise. And then it will be the halfway mark of the competition and a chance to take stock of the scores. competition taking place in the Shibuya area of the city of Tokyo, as Angelina Melnikova takes to the floor exercise. It is a superbly put together routine, that, from Angelina Melnikova. Yes, there was a little bit of difficulty with the very final tumbling pass, but what a spectacular opening to the whole routine. And all blended together with really nice choreography. But isn't this such a stylish moment, the double layout, and then the height that she achieves. Memel turns really very secure, very stable, very elegant. And she made light of that, didn't she, at the end, almost making it an intentional part of the choreography. Yes, okay, the judges will notice. Jackie Hadakeda, she impressed on the floor exercise with a score of 13. Now, this could be a big vault. Indeed so, very promising once more from Chiaki Hatakeda. We'll come back to that in just a moment and collect her score. Yes, there we go, 14.2. Execution not as high as Shai Jones, but otherwise a lot that was highly comparable. 13.4 on the floor for Melnikova. Surely going to be a counting score there for Team Friendship. Now, what do we see from Sophia Butler of the United States of America? Really interesting routine. Some very proficient tumbling from Sophia Butler. Had a little loss of stability in some of the turn work. We look back at Asuka Teramoto's performance, also representing Team Friendship. Champion on floor at the All Japan Event Championships last year. There is undeniably a real sense of musicality to Asuka Teramoto on floor. Lovely choreography in the middle of the routine especially. And her score 13.2. So again, a score of some significance for Team Friendship. Sophia Butler, 12.4 for her. So on the parallel bars, the Team Friendship, Kazuma Kaya, Yuya Komoto, and the American gymnast Yul Moldauer posting the strongest three scores for Team Friendship. The floor exercise also now completed. No surprise about the top score on the horizontal bar, Kohei Uchimura, and no surprise as well about the top score on vault for Team Solidarity, Shai Jones. 14.8 for her. That is impressive stuff. And it means, therefore, that we have ourselves a little change to things. Because now it is Team Solidarity, after a solid performance in that last rotation, who have gone into the lead. 255.1 plays 252. But we're only at the halfway mark of the whole competition. So what a big turnaround that was for Team Solidarity. 3.1 now their advantage. Just worth taking a moment to reflect upon the whole motivation of this competition, the origins of the name. But this is a competition not about competing for national glory. Yes, the athletes are wearing the national colours, but this is really a celebration of the sport of gymnastics more than anything else. And it's a much needed celebration of the sport of gymnastics. We've been wanting competition for some time, but it's been important that the competition takes place in a safe setting. And this is a very important test of that, with big things potentially on the horizon for the city of Tokyo, of course. So we are going to begin rotation number 4 in just a short while. Jorge Uchimura is due to be competing on the floor exercise, where he has delivered many a beautiful performance over the years. So Team Solidarity, they take to the floor exercise and to the uneven bars. And Team Friendship, their attention is on the horizontal bar and the women's vault. Asuka Teramoto to vault for Team Friendship. This is the last time that we'll see her competing. It is very hard to believe that Asuka Teramoto suffered a ruptured Achilles back in February. So terrific has been her recovery and her rehabilitation. She really is a hardy and tough athlete. And she's had a fine day at the office today. Nikita Nagorny competing on floor. First time we've had a chance to see the men competing in the floor exercise. Just puts a lot of very interesting elements together. It really was his year last year. Just had such a superb 12 months. And if he can carry what was going on in 2019 through into 2021 and put this year of disruption to one side, then there is the gymnast that everybody will watch heading in to the Olympic Games. He's famous for his challenges on social media, is Nikita Nagorny. I think there are a lot of gymnastics fans out there who watch some of the things he does on his social media platforms and thinks, just be a little bit careful there. You are the reigning world champion heading into the Olympics. Maybe don't do standing double back somersaults on mattresses. But he rather enjoys it, and it entertains a lot of people. Asuka Teramoto scores 13.7. on the vault. Now, Dmitry Lankin has got some big work on the floor exercise. 23-year-old from Rostov, but based in Moscow, like the gentleman we just had a look at before, Nikita Nagorny. Bronze medalist on the floor at the European Games. That's his big one to get things started. That lovely Nukin triple back tuck somersault. Aren't many people out there doing that. But boy, can he twist as well. Easy to see why Lankin was the Russian champion on floor last year. think his reaction was our reaction at the end of that. He's exciting, isn't he, Dimitri Lankin? Does some really interesting things on the floor exercise. You do have to be of a certain standard, of a very high certain standard, if you're going to win the Russian title. And it's that starting point, that heavy, high difficulty first tumbling pass, getting that extra rotation in compared to what most athletes are doing. Now, will it be rewarded with a big, big number? Next up, a man who's already made his mark today. I mentioned his mum earlier. She scored 8.6 out of 10 on floor at the Masters Championships. Now we'll see what the son can do. Just a reminder in case it was needed. Six consecutive World Championship all-around titles from 2009 to 2015. 10 gold medals at World Championship level, along with his 3 Olympic titles, 2 of them in the all-around competition. And so when you hear a man like Kohei Uchimura say Tokyo 2020 is the biggest goal of his life, you take it seriously, because he has surpassed goals bigger than just about any other athlete will encounter in their career. And what it's taught us over the years is that when Kohei Uchimura decides he's going to do something, well, he just jolly well goes on and does it. I look back at Nikita Nagorny scoring a 14.2 on floor. We'll bring you Dimitri Lankin's score just as soon as we can as well. Well, I suggested earlier, asked the question, what has been going on in his head over the past 18 months or so? Whatever it has been, his thoughts are probably significantly happier after what happened in that last rotation. .14 the score for Dimitri Lankin. Spectators adhering to the social distancing rules and providing an important test of how it looks and feels logistically, but also atmospherically, to have competitions with spectators. They've been doing that for a while in Japan as elite sport has resumed, just testing the water both at indoor and outdoor events. The Japanese Football League was one of the first in the world to resume with spectators in controlled conditions, and other sports are starting to follow suit. And as you can see, the spectators are keeping to the rules. Kohei Uchimura, competing on the floor exercise. Well, his performance on the floor at the World Championships in this city in 2011 will be regarded as one of the most perfect pieces of gymnastics of all time. If you judge everything Kohei Uchimura does by that standard, then nothing will ever meet it. But it is just very delightful to see Uchimura competing with confidence and looking like the gymnast that we know and love. Liu Yufei of the People's Republic of China, representing Team Solidarity on the uneven bars, reigning Asian champion on this piece. Linking some elements nicely, going into that ginga well. Hugely popular gymnast. And she's just a little bit off on her line there, unfortunately. Hasn't competed at many FIG events. But it is worth setting into context, although that right there was not Liu Yufei's finest ever moment. She's just achieved a wonderful moment personally for her, having won her first medal at the Chinese National Championships back in September. She was the bronze medalist on the floor exercise. It was a long time coming for the 20-year-old, and I think meant a great deal to her and her small army of fans. Well, aside from that loss of contact going for the regrasp, lots that was very good. 13.5 for Uchimura, keeping the difficulty controlled, not going for more than necessary. Just a reminder, he's not focusing on the floor exercise anymore in the way he used to. Wataru Tanigawa, though, most certainly is, because he's got his eye on all-around prizes. And he's had a pretty decent day so far. Super control in the manner position. Very nice sense of symmetry to his diagonal armed handstand too. Just has moments where he loses some of the tidiness in his leg form when he's twisting. Looked more secure in terms of the lower body in the conclusion of that routine. Kept his legs much tidier in that last tumbling pass. He's performed very well on the floor in the FIG World Cup events that he's participated in over the years. Judges just looking to see there's no needless bending of the knees. The athletes are straight-legged when they need to be. Does really jackknife his body well, though, doesn't he, in the V position, or manner position, as it's sometimes known. Liu Yufei picking up a score of 12.4 on the uneven bars. A look back at Yul Moldauer of the United States of America on the horizontal bar representing Team Friendship. The US national all-around champion a few years ago. Very well known for his excellent performances at the FIG World Cup in America. Yeah, it was a little bit wild going into that, unfortunately. Gymnast who has had a very impressive collegiate career at Oklahoma. And again, as he struggles with that release and regrasp, we remind ourselves that this is an athlete who was under a stay-at-home order in the spring, and so he turned his garage into a gym with a pommel horse in there with rings hung from the ceiling and some mats in there. But obviously you can't chuck a horizontal bar into your garage, not without banging your head anyway. So he's had a limited time on this particular piece. Signs that the readjustment will go well for Yul Moldauer in time as he scores 12.1 on the horizontal bar. Said he's really enjoyed this trip, but he'll bring a games console next time if he's restricted and has to stay in the hotel. 14.2 for Wataru Tanigawa on the floor exercise. Lots of good signs from him. So we move into the second half of rotation number four, using the split warm-up format. And Sophia Butler of the United States of America is going to be the first to vault. Last performance here from the gymnast representing Team Friendship. A great lover of literature, really enjoys the study of English. Very active in animal welfare as well. Has a great social conscience. And a great bit of vaulting too from Sophia Butler. That's a really nice conclusion to her competition. Looking more tidy than she did on the balance beam and the floor exercise, certainly. So promising signs there. Sticking with Team Friendship on the horizontal bar is Arta Dalaloyan. He says he's been feeling excited by the opportunity to prepare new routines. So perhaps explaining why some things have been a little bit not to his usual standard in terms of his landings today. Chance for experimentation in some quarters. But this is looking good. It was looking good. I've got to stop saying that because I seem to be rather jinxing Arthur Dalloloyan today. Well, again, we take all of this with a pinch of salt and a pinch of chalk. This is just part of the process, isn't it? Getting back to where the world all-around champion from a couple of years ago was, and where he doubtless can go back to. He said a very interesting thing, actually, about missing training and missing competing. He said the most useful thing was getting to see his child grow, getting to be there for his family. Back to that old notion of perspective again. Just seemed to check himself there as he landed. Hope all is okay. Yes, it looks as though he's walking fine. Just wondered if he'd tweaked something as he concluded that routine. Just worth in those slow motion replays, especially from that kind of angle, seeing what kind of visibility the athlete has of the bar when they're going in for their re-grasp. And in situations like that with Dalloloyan, not much visibility actually. See the bar very late. 13.5 for Sophia Butler, her strongest work of the day to bring her competition to a close. Alexandra Shkoldina, representing Team Solidarity here on the uneven bars. Made her World Championship debut last year, picking up the team silver medal. Little step sideways as she landed in otherwise a very secure looking routine from the 18-year-old. Dalloloyan scores 12.9 on the horizontal bar. Still has the floor exercise and the pommel horse to come. Chance to see Alexei Rostov on the horizontal bar. He's best known for his work on this piece, the 27-year-old. He had qualified for the final in Baku at the World Cup as the second strongest before it was cancelled. Like his teammate, some difficulties. Perhaps on one of the elements that he wouldn't have expected to have problems. If you are a horizontal bar specialist, or at least best known for your work on that apparatus, then it is very hard for you to be training when you haven't got access to your training gym. One thing to have a pommel horse fitted at home, but some things are just plain old impractical. Again, Alexei Rostov just a little bit off kilter on his landing. Shkoldina scores 13.5 on the uneven bars. 8 for execution for her. Alexei Rostov with a score of 13 on the horizontal bar. So we keep our focus with team friendship and a look at Kazuma Kaya on the horizontal bar. One of the athletes who is a graduate of Juntendo, founded in 1838 as a medical school, but has expanded since and is so famous for the gymnasts it's produced, the likes of Takahiro Kashima, Ryohei Kato, Yusuke Tanaka, Hiroyuki Tomita, Isao Yoneda. All have come through the ranks at Jundai. He's being very careful with his releases and re-grasps, leaving little room for error. That's a nice sequence of close control work. Lovely fluidity, like a knife through butter there. Stabilizes his landing at the second attempt, and as ever from Kazuma Kaya, there's a degree of cleanliness to what he produces on the competition floor. Very popular, very well regarded. Gymnast who is so often there or thereabouts in all-around competition at world championship level. Sixth place at the last two competitions. Can he just go that little bit further? Can he find a little bit of difficulty here and there in places? Tenth here, a tenth there. Just start to push up towards the podium. 23, so time on his side in that quest. ...14.3 for Kazuma Kaya on the horizontal bar. Yuya Kamoto next to compete for Team Friendship on the horizontal bar. This is due to be the last time we see him in the competition, as he was not originally designated to compete on the floor exercise of the pommel horse. Dad Kenji was a national level gymnast. Having a few problems on the horizontal bar today. May indeed as well be the case that some of these athletes will suffer from a touch of competition fatigue as things go on. Again, there is a real difference between training and prepping for a competition and then actually getting out there and doing it. And if I'm sounding a little bit like a broken record just talking about the time that's been missed, it's because it's worth repeatedly reminding ourselves of that, because gymnasts make things look very, very easy. They make almost superhuman things look very, very easy. But they are human, and they do need time to readjust to competition. Nice pirouette work on the bar there from Kamoto. And he holds his landing well. As ever, there's so much that's memorable and exciting about Yuya Kamoto. Even when things don't quite go according to plan, he just performs with a certain style and a certain joy. Yelena Gerasimova of the Russian Federation of Team Solidarity, competing on the uneven bars, the senior international debut for the gymnast from Cheboksary on the Volga River. He was a silver medalist, as things don't quite go according to plan there on the uneven bars at the Russian Junior National Championships last year. Like a lot of the Russian gymnasts, has a very keen interest in ballet. Did actually want to be a ballerina when she was a child. I think it's something that has been much talked about in Russian gymnastics over the years, is the awareness of balletic techniques that their athletes have. Again, a nice recovery from Yelena Gerasimova. Not the senior international debut she would have expected to have. As Yuya Kamoto seems to be carrying everyone's luggage. 13.3. 12.9 for Yelena Gerasimova on the uneven bars. So that draws to a close the fourth rotation. And these are the scores that are counting. Melnikova's 14.7 on vault, the best for Team Friendship, and Kaya's 14.3 on the horizontal bar. Lankin with his 14.4 score. Thought that came through as a 14.1 originally. May have been upgraded, or I may have misread it. So here's the top score on the floor exercise, and for Solidarity, Shkoldina's 13.5 on the uneven bars, their best score. So all of that leads us to Team Solidarity remaining in the lead, but things are a little bit closer than they were just a short while ago. 335.9 the score for Team Friendship, 337.6 for Team Solidarity. So a 1.7 mark advantage, down from a 3.1 advantage. You know, it's worth repeating a story that I told at the start of the broadcast, that the Yoyogi First Gymnasium, it's just down the road from Shibuya Station in central Tokyo, and it was here in the 1920s that a scientist called Hidesaburo Ueno used to take the train to work, and every day his dog Hachiko would meet him outside the station upon his return, and they would journey back home together. And one day Mr. Ueno very sadly died whilst he was at work, and he didn't return, but his dog Hachiko did. Every day for 9 years waited for his friend, for his master to come back, and in 1934 they built a statue for Hachiko in the very place where he waited, not too far at all from this building. It's become one of the most famous landmarks in Japan. And where Hachiko once waited, now travelers from all over the place, they wait by what has come to be known as the meeting dog. And they stand by the statue of Hachiko to wait for their friends, for their loved ones, in the belief that they will one day meet again, someday. Dear old Hachiko, he taught us all, didn't he, that friendship matters, and that from friendship you get a true sense of solidarity. Kohei Uchimura competing on the pommel horse. The It's got splendid clearance going on here. And this is where it will be interesting to see if any of the gymnasts are becoming a little fatigued, because pommel horses, where you can see it sometimes. Not so far for King Kohe. Oh, very good. Just been great to see him out there competing. That's him done for the day. He's not going to do the still rings. And good, good signs for Kohe Uchimura. Great promise. How strange it feels to be talking about Kohe Uchimura as a marginal prospect for the Olympic Games. There's not the first name on the team sheet, but things are very different now. But we're seeing signs of the Uchimura of days gone by. His score is 13.3 again, just keeping the difficulty nice and contained, focusing on the execution and getting back out there and performing. From Uchimura and Team Solidarity to Team Friendship, competing on the floor. Just the male gymnasts now performing in these last couple of rotations, and it is Shane Whiskus who is set to get things underway for his team. Team that is now playing catch up on the scoreboard. Well, I mentioned it earlier that well, it's actually going to be Alexei Rostov that we focus on, who is the third gymnast to compete. My apologies, Shane Whiskus already performing his routine. Try to bring you the score of that just as soon as possible. A little bit low there, but he held it well. Good clearance with his feet off the mat in the Russian Wendeschwing. Just steps out towards the conclusion of the routine, but better there from Rostov after things were not quite according to plan on the horizontal bar. Wataru Tanigawa competes on the pommel horse. His heels in nicely. Really got to keep that clearance going, otherwise he's going to clip the pommels. Just trying to keep his legs tidy and together. That's It's getting pretty close, but it looks like he's going to power his way through. This is Wataru Tanigawa, and he is very well. That is some strength and conditioning on display from Wataru Tanigawa in what's going to be regarded as a very positive day for him. Had some good success in Tokyo in World Cup events. We are with Kazuma Kaya on the floor for Team Friendship. Rapid Russians. Always sets himself for a nice handstand. All did well, because just for a moment there, looked as though he was coming down a touch supine. Well, again, one expects consistency with Kazuma Kaya. One tends to get consistency with Kazuma Kaya. And one is seeing it with Wataru Tanigawa as well. 14 his score on the pommel horse. And it's a real test now of the competition conditioning of these athletes. A good test too. First chance we've had to see Paul Judah of the United States of America, the 19-year-old from Illinois. Youngest member of the national team setup. Some good flares. Got his toe point nicely sorted out as well during them. It's exciting and difficult work. Smoothly transition into his dismount. Yes, he can. Very fine from the University of Michigan student. Electrical engineering major. 13.4 is the score for Rostov on the floor. Kazuma Kaya with a 14.1. On the floor exercise, that likely to be an important score for his team. Paul Judah looking pretty pleased as punch. He said that the absence of gymnastics made him love the sport more. He said, you never know how stressed out you are until you take a break, which is a very interesting comment to make, actually, a very apposite one. I think a lot of people have found that of late. He did lots of Zoom workouts, exercise bike work, gymnastics on furniture at home, and then he got back into the gym, realized why he loved the sport in the first place. 13.4 is the score for Paul Judah. He was inspired by Uchimura at London 2012 as a young gymnast, so gosh, you have to wonder what it will mean to him to be competing on the same team as him today. It's got to be an enormous honour for the teenager from the United States. Rotation number 5 is at the halfway point, or beyond the halfway point really, because we just have Nikita Nagorny to compete on the pommel horse, and then two Chinese gymnasts, Shi Kong, who's just walking away from the floor, and then Zhang Boheng to compete on the floor exercise. And we move to the sixth and final rotation. There is a very nice feeling of camaraderie about this place. Yep, that's right. We've all just seen you taking that selfie. Oh, it's just what you want to see, isn't it? Sports people being happy back in the workplace. As they smile, so we smile. And so we start to enjoy gymnastics once more. Hope you're having fun watching at home. Ollie Hockman here, bringing you all of the coverage from this friendship and solidarity competition being run by Japan Gymnastics and the International Gymnastics Federation, the FIG. Thumbs up to this competition, most definitely. They're all out of practice, aren't they, these gymnasts, at these little moments. The routines are fine. It's just the little transitions when they're sitting down. They've got to go back in the gym and work on those now. It's like seeing a rhythmic gymnast who's forgotten how to throw a towel down. Lovely space is the Yoyogi First Gymnasium. Was designed by Kenzo Tange for the 1964 Olympic Games. Nikita Nagorny competing on the pommel horse. A little bit of leg bend there, and he rescued it well, but the leg form has just deteriorated a touch as he has to bend the knees a little bit just to clear the apparatus. And the strength that he's showing and actually not coming off is quite something to behold, because really he should have been sitting down on that pommel horse about five or six times. Oh, he's a strong chap, is Nikita Nagorny. Fist bumps all round and a few bumps on the apparatus too. Shi Kong of the People's Republic of China now competing on the floor exercise. We'll take some penalties there for that first sequence. 19-year-old from Jiangsu on the east coast of China. The Grand Canal runs through, making it a real economic hub. First time that he's represented his country at senior level, though he is a medalist on floor at junior continental level. Nice height right at the end. Just takes a little stutter and step. Nagorny with a 14.2 score on the pommel horse. 8.3 execution for him. Plenty of good signs, though, we've seen from Nagorny so far today. Shi Kong's international teammate Zhang Boheng is still to perform on the floor. And that will bring rotation number five to a close. Lots to ponder for some of these athletes, for whom some things have gone right and some things have not gone as right. But this is just one of many steps back on the road. Shi Kong scores 13.3 on the floor, picking up that 0.3 penalty for going out of bounds at the start. Zhang Boheng, who started very well with a 14.7 on the still rings, a really key score for his team. He was fourth on floor at the Chinese Championships in Zhaoqing a couple of months ago. He was really unfortunate, actually, at those championships. He was fourth on floor, he was fourth on parallel bars, and he was part of the Hunan province team that also came fourth. Brought himself to a stop with real neatness. Lots to enjoy about the work of Zhang Boheng on the floor exercise. Didn't compete on vault and the parallel bars, but he has a cleanliness to his work, sense of precision. And his performance brings to a close rotation number five. For Zhang Boheng on the floor. And we'll now get a sense of how important that score is. The answer is very important. That is a counting score for Team Friendship, along with Shane Whiskas and Kazuma Kaya. Yin Dehang, Nikita Nagorny and Wataru Tanigawa contributing to a 42.4 on the pommel horse for Team Solidarity. So we move round for the final time to the last rotation. And it's going to be to the pommel horse for Team Friendship, and to the still rings for Team Solidarity. That means that this is where we are moving into the final rotation, and it certainly is competitive right down to these last few performances. Gap of just a mark and a half, and it is Team Solidarity who has the advantage. But again, all of that with the caveat that we are far more concerned about the gymnastics than we are the numbers. On this occasion, let's just indulge in that for a short while, because it's going to be all about the numbers very soon again. And 2021 is looking like it could be a very busy year for the sport. chance to preserve some lovely memories, especially for these gymnasts who are making their senior international debuts. And there, our representation of friendship and solidarity. It's one of the things that we take for granted most about gymnastics is the respect for all competitors as they're all trying to work out the right way to do the S for solidarity more successfully than Kohei Uchimura. Kohei Uchimura has excelled at the thing he needed to today, and that's all that matters. So the sixth and final rotation. Steel rings for Team Solidarity, pommel horse for Team Friendship. So might well be a bit of a tall order for Team Friendship. They've got a mark and a half to make up going into this final rotation. We begin with Arta Della Loyan. They are due to be putting seven up on the pommel horse. There are just six routines on the steel rings. Well into the flares, and now just trying to pick up the pace is Della Loyan. He gets through that routine without too many great difficulties, as Arta Della Loyan will go away and reflect on some things that have gone according to plan and some things that have gone slightly less according to plan. Ma Yue of the People's Republic of China. First chance we've had to look at him. He's known for his work on the steel rings. He's been a World Cup gold medalist, the 22-year-old from Anhui province, and also a double Youth Olympic champion a Youth Olympic silver medalist in 2014, including on the steel rings. That's a difficult skill. Swallow position, as it used to be known. Yamawaki tidily into the handstand. He's an exciting athlete on the rings, is Ma Yue. .14 is the score for him. Della Loyan, .13.2 to bring to a close his competition. Chance to catch up once again with Alexei Rostov. He was fourth on the pommel horse at last year's Russian National Championships. Clips the pommels, but gets his leg position back well. Just loses the leg form moving into the dismount, but again it's well rescued, minimised some fairly hefty execution deductions. They will still be quite sizeable. A little bit of an irritated look from himself. Yinde Hang next to compete on the still rings as Team Solidarity could be closing in on the victory. Senior international debut for this gymnast. He was, just like his teammate Ma Yue, a medalist at the Youth Olympic Games on the still rings, just 4 years later though, in his case. He's a brave young lad. He was born in Guizhou in the southwest of China, based in Beijing now, which is, although in the same country, 2,000 kilometers away. It's the equivalent of a teenager moving from London to Casablanca in Morocco for training. It requires a lot of heart to do something like that, and to do something like that. Promising young athlete. 13.1 for Rostov on the pommel horse, 7.5 execution. They did all rather add up, those little moments. We have seen a lot of the dependable Kazumakaya today. Came to a lot of people's attention in Glasgow in 2015 at the World Championships when he won a pommel horse bronze medal, along with that impressive team title. Added to his individual World Championship collection with a bronze on the parallel bars in Stuttgart last year. That was a crisp beginning. Oh, as was that, that's lovely. He's our very neat gymnast, is Kazumakaya. Everything is so contained and controlled. Then he comes off the apparatus and whoops and cheers, as we probably all whoop and cheer with him. 13.4 for Yinde Hang for his work on the still rings. Kazumakaya scores 14.8 on the pommel horse. It's another very good performance on a very fine day for Kazumakaya. The man from nearby Chiba Prefecture. Can see why he's the reigning Japanese champion. And we can usually see why he is the reigning world champion. One of the great dependable gymnasts out there. So to Nikita Nagorny, the last gymnast in the first half of this final rotation before the next set of gymnasts will have the chance to warm up. Won the Russian title on this piece last year, along with everything else apart from floor, where he won the silver. He is the only active Russian gymnast to have national titles on all six pieces. Really stable handstand work. Really a gymnast who always seems to look as though he's in control of the apparatus and the apparatus is never in control of him. We look back at Paul Judah on the still rings. The position transitioning into the straddle planche worked well. Starts with the Jonas and then into the Yamawaki. More commonly done the other way. Just takes a moment to re-establish his handstand. Only a few flickers that time. 13 the score for Paul Judah. A well-executed routine, 8.4. Nagorny's score is 14.7. Matches his number on the parallel bars. I'm sure there are many of you out there who are rather studiously looking at the numbers for the individual gymnasts as well. But there is no individual award in this competition. It is simply about the teams. So the second half of this final rotation, it's all coming to an end rather too quickly. Just when we were really starting to have some fun. After Dalaloyan and Alexei Rostov having a chat, and now Dalaloyan just having a bit of a think. His teammates Zhang Boheng, Yul Moldau and Shane Wiskasser to perform on the pommel horse, and then over on the still rings, Dmitry Lankin and Wataru Tanegawa. His job is done. Kohei Uchimura can just sit and watch now, having delivered very clean and tidy gymnastics along with one show stealer on the horizontal bar. So that is where we are at the moment. Team Friendship 419.6, Team Solidarity 422.5. They have extended their advantage. Well, Team Solidarity are in the driving seat. Dmitry Lankin competing on the still rings. Gymnast who delivered their strongest performance on the floor exercise, an important score. So whatever happens here, he's played his part in what's looking like it's going to be a win for them. Holds the Maltese neatly. Swing of those rings to bring under control, which looks like he's done. gets a little supportive call out from one of his teammates there to hold that handstand, and it seemed to work and do the trick. Dmitry Lankin has made his mark today. Zhang Boheng is the first competitor in the second half of this rotation for Team Friendship on the pommel horse. Still his showpiece moment, that performance on Still Rings at the start of the day. Lovely, precise hand placement. Magyarta Shivado combination. Needs a little bit of strength in the core just to get through into that dismount, but he did so well. It's 13.8 for Zhang Boheng. And Dmitry Lankin picks up 14.5, a score that is really going to help Team Solidarity maintain their advantage. Wakaru Tanikawa, another of the standout gymnasts really of the day. So good to see him delivering fine performances across all apparatuses after not being able to compete on everything at the World Championships. And certainly his competition fitness is holding up well. That's another really good performance from Wataru Tanikawa. Some impressive gymnastics from the Japanese all around us today. To Shane Wiskus, the final gymnast competing for Team Friendship. And indeed, the final performance of the competition. And again, it's just worth restating what kind of a year Shane Wiskus has had with his University of Minnesota announcing that men's gymnastics would not be continuing after the coming season. So he's made the move to the US Olympic and Paralympic Training Center. That's happening next month. Completing his degree online. Just shown himself to be a thoroughly flexible, an industrious individual. Just got problems with the leg bend there, and that tends to catch up with you on the pommel horse. Very often when an athlete comes off, you can look back three or four moves before and see where the slide starts to happen. You know what, he's been through tougher things this year and he's come out fighting. So no worries over Shane Wiskus. More to come from this gentleman. More to come, certainly. He's been working with a sports psychologist as well to really develop his mentality. said it was difficult to get into competitive shape. He rushed to put some of his routines together for this competition. But there are most certainly signs of what is to come. 13.9 for Wataru Tanigawa on the still rings. His only sub 14 score of the day. Shane Whisker scores 12.7 on the pommel horse. And we await confirmation of what seems pretty likely, which is the victory for Team Solidarity. But let's just indulge in that rather cliched expression, because sometimes it's true that this is about a victory for gymnastics today more than anything else. Nikita Nagorny looking in fine fettle, producing a 14.7 on the still rings. His teammate Dimitri Lankin also very impressive, with Ma Yue making up the top three in the counting scores. Over on the pommel horse, it's Kazuma Kaya who's been one of the talking points of the day. Yul Moldauer, 14.2, and Zhang Boheng, 13.8. Job extremely well done by Kazuma Kaya. Should we be surprised? Of course not, because Kazuma Kaya is a linchpin of the team. So we're going to have the final results announced to the spectators, and indeed to you. They're all glancing up at the scoreboard now. And we have confirmation of the victory for Team Solidarity. Victorious by a score of 2.3. And this splendidly entertaining competition here at the Yoyogi First Gymnasium. That's a rather nice moment, isn't it? Just goes to show that anyone can be starstruck. And we should all remember, shouldn't we, that at the heart of it, just as we are fans, they are fans too. They love this sport, just as humble spectators love this sport. And in the company of Kohei Uchimura, you are always a humble spectator. Well, plenty of talking points that have come out of this competition. We'll have the presentation in just a short while, so do please stay with us to enjoy the victory ceremony. Well, it's a job well done by the staff here, by the organising committee, and by those that look after the Yoyogi First Gymnasium, or the Yoyogi Daiichi Taikukan, to give it its proper name in Japanese. Lovely building. It's been very well suited to hosting a test event like this. It is set to host handball at the Olympics next year. It hosted swimming and diving back in 1964. And it's hosted this competition wonderfully. And as Kohei Uchimura was writing his name in kanji there, the Japanese characters, I was reminded of the significance of those pictorial characters and the things that they mean. And it's worth just reflecting on the fact that Yoyogi itself means generation of trees. Are we in a time of regrowth? Are we seeing the first little signs of life in the sport of gymnastics? Here in Shibuya, a special ward of Tokyo, its name means the bitter valley. But there is a little bit of sweetness today at this competition, because it's been so wonderful to see gymnastics taking place once again. Well, I was a touch premature in announcing a victory ceremony. Force of habit, I'm afraid. There isn't a victory ceremony in this competition because it is very much about the team effort and the spirit of collaboration. And it brings to a close our coverage here of this FIG Friendship and Solidarity competition at the Yoyogi First Gymnasium. And you know what? We've waited a while for gymnastics in Tokyo, and I think it's been worth it. Who knows what more there is to come in the months ahead, but it's been an absolute joy having your company for this competition and getting to welcome you once again to international gymnastics. It's been a joy for the gymnasts as well. That much has been clear from watching them compete. So until the next time, whenever the next time might be, I've been Ollie Hogben, and it's been a pleasure to have your company.
Please watch your step as it will be dark in the